I was lucky this time that there was nobody in the queue when I first came and requested the lock. But another time, I may not be that lucky. There may be somebody else using the lock already. And if that is the case, then what I would have to do is to queue myself in this data structure. And the way I do that is to indicate by setting the last pointer in this list to point to me. This pointer is always pointing to the last requester. In this case, the original case that I showed you, I was the only requester that was also last requester. But now, the queue has somebody using that particular lock. And so when I come in, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set this field of the lock data structure, the dummy node, the head node of the lock data structure to point to me. I'm the last requester. And I'm also going to fix up the linked list so that the current guy is going to point to me. And why am I doing this? Well, the reason I do this is because when he is done using the lock, he needs to reach out and signal me. What am I going to be doing? I'm going to be spinning. And what am I spinning on? I'm spinning on the guarded flag. So this is a data structure that is associated with me. And one of the fields you know is the guarded field in the data structure. So I'm going to spin on this guarded field in the data structure, waiting for this guy to set it to true. So I'll initialize it to false when I came in and formed this request. When I formed this request, what I did was to set myself as the last requester. I'll clear out this field to indicate that I don't have the lock. And I'll set up the linked list so that the current lock holder points to me through his next field. And my next field, of course, is nil because there's no requester after me. So once I've fixed up this linked list in this fashion, then I basically can spin on my guarded Boolean variable.